Hey guys, this is Eric Tarr for theproaudiophiles.com. In this video, I'll show you how to use the basic types of equalizers to create some complex spectral curves. The foundational concept behind this is to understand that different EQ bands can interact with each other in cool ways. In other words, you shouldn't think that each band in an equalizer has to be independent. In fact, you can get very creative if you start to combine them together. Here are some ideas that I came up with, but there are certainly plenty of other techniques too. I'd love to see you guys post some of your own ideas below in the comments after checking out the video. Let's get to my session. Here I'm going to be working with a country track. In fact, you guys can find these audio files online and download them yourself. They come from a website called mixnotes.com. It's put out by a good friend of mine, Jonathan Roy. He's got this song as well as plenty of other songs in different genres that are up there that you guys can go and find and download and practice some of your mixing, practice some of these techniques yourself. So, let me play it back and give you an idea about what I'm going to be working with.
We were heading into town with the radio loud. She was sitting shotgun at her window rolled down to...
Alright, I'll start out with something pretty straightforward. Now there are some famous equalizers that are known for having some unique spectral curves precisely because they have interacting bands. One example of this is the Poltec style equalizer. And there's a famous trick with the low frequencies where you can boost and cut at the same time around the same frequency. In reality, this trick involves nothing more than the interaction of two low shelves. So here's how you can accomplish the Poltec trick without a Poltec equalizer. I'm going to show you this here with my kick drum. So I'll go ahead and solo it and let you hear what my kick drum sounds like. Now this trick is good for the kick drum. It's also good for other bass instruments like your electric bass guitar. Sometimes it even works well across a full mix. I'm going to go ahead and bring up an equalizer here. This one is the Isotope Ozone Equalizer that comes as part of Ozone 6. Now, you don't necessarily have to use this equalizer, and in fact, the thing that I want you to know is you can use almost any equalizer that has the basic curves of an equalizer, a low shelf, a bell, a high shelf, and I'm just going to be working and combining those things together. So you don't have to use Ozone, you can use your stock EQ plugin in Pro Tools or in Logic or maybe another one. As long as it's got those basic shapes, you don't have to have a special one like a Poltec equalizer or some of the other ones I'm going to talk about later on too. So the way that the Poltec equalizer trick works is that you're going to be boosting a low shelf and cutting with a low shelf. It just so happens that the low shelf that you're cutting with actually starts at a little bit higher frequency or has a more gradual curve that's sloping down. So I've got this already set up ahead of time. For band one here, I'm going to be using this one as my boost. So I've just got my basic low shelf right here. Thing about the Poltec curve is that it allows you with attenuation and boost to actually carve out a little bit of the low mids, and that's why it sounds good with your kick drum. So what I can do here is pull this one down. I've got set up at 200 hertz. You can see that I'm starting to decrease here around my low mids, but I'm still boosting up those really low frequencies down around 100 hertz or below where the fundamental frequency of the kick drum is. Now, I have a lot of control here because I have the gain of my second one. If I turn this one off, you can see it's just a regular low shelf. These are starting to interact with each other to have this cool shape. Now I have the nice degree of freedom here with gain where I can maybe cut this one more. Then I can go back to band one, boost it just like you would if you like that control as you would with a Poltec equalizer. You have same kind of control if you set up the low shelves yourself. The added advantage over the Poltec equalizer is you have independent control frequencies for these low shelves. So I could sweep this one lower here if I wanted, then boost it up more, I can make it go higher, and so on. Variable control now over the same style of curves. Same thing here, I can sweep this up even higher, maybe boost it down lower, or attenuate it more lower or less, and so on. So this is one way with your equalizers, just basic low shelves, that you can create this kind of interaction that you would normally only find on a Poltec equalizer. Let me play you back my kick drum and play around with it a little bit so I can show you what it can sound like. Scoop out some of the low mids with one low shelf, but then beef up my low end with the other one. I don't wanna scoop this over a little bit more, pull out more of the low mids. All right, so that's pretty straightforward technique. Let me move on to something that is a little bit more complex, I guess, than that. I'll go ahead and make this one inactive. I'm gonna focus on my acoustic guitar now. All right, now what I'm gonna demonstrate is how you can make a bell-shaped curve with a flat top. Go ahead and bring up Ozone for this. And this is a shape that is found on a special kind of equalizer. It's pretty new. It's called the Eosis Air EQ. I hope I'm saying that company's name right. This EQ is fairly new, so if you haven't seen it before, I highly recommend you go and check it out. The basic idea is to have a bell curve that doesn't have a resonant peak top. It's almost like having a mid shelf instead of having like just a high shelf or a low shelf. So let me show you how you can create this a couple of different ways just by using basic EQ curves rather than having something special or fancy. So here I'm going to start out. First time, I'll show you it here. Let me switch over to surgical mode here. With high shelf that I'm going to be doing, and I'm just going to set up so it kind of has a plateau shape rather than having a bell curve in the mid frequencies. I can set up that something that has a flat top. So what I'll do here with band 3 is boost by 2 dB. Band 4, I'm going to cut by 2 dB. So what I need to do is raise this one up. You can see that the interacting bands start to have a bell curve here. As I continue to increase the frequency, you'll see that I have now a flat top, right? So I can make this as wide or narrow as I want, flat top. What this is going to do is kind of flatten off that resonant peak that sometimes comes up and makes your curve sound too sharp. Maybe you want it to boost for my acoustic guitar here. Without sounding too harsh. So let me play it back and maybe do a little bit of that. Bring up my low mids, or my upper mids. I can do it even, make the gain higher. Maybe I raise this one up to 3. This one. I can also do the opposite. Let me go back to 2 here. You can also do the same thing where you're cutting with a flat bottom of your bell like this. You know, I can sweep this one over. Can make this one go over here as well. I can, you know, hollow out the center of my spectrum if I wanted to. It's really up to you to be creative as you start to see how these things can interact. Now this is with the high shelf. Another way that you can accomplish a similar kind of thing, let's do this with bells. So I got a bell here. Let me boost it up like this. Maybe widen out the Q a little bit. Let's add another bell in here, right? Let me see what this one is. 2.8. Let me make this one 2.8 as well. Like this. Gain. Now, what's my Q? 2.3. Okay, let me do that so it's symmetrical. 2.3. Good. Now I'll just move the frequency like this. You can see now what's happening is that I have a flat top. And if I start to work these two together here, I can sweep these around. And so on. If I move this one to like this, you can see that now what I've accomplished is I have this flat top and so on. You know, these things are interacting with each other. I could broaden out the Q and make this wider or so on. I could even do things like raise the gain on these things. Right? It's a different way of going about having a flat top rather than a single bell curve. I can put two of them together or two high shelves or low shelves and accomplish a similar kind of thing. All right, the last technique that I'll show you, I'm gonna demonstrate on my vocals. So let me go over here to my lead vocals and find a part where their person is singing. Right here, seems good. All right. So last thing I'll demonstrate is how to make a bell-shaped curve with an asymmetrical shape. So rather than having a flat top, in this case, it's going to be asymmetrical. And there are several EQs that have this kind of option. One idea that comes to my mind is the Waves Hybrid EQ. If you're not familiar with it, you should definitely check it out. The idea is have to have a bell curve where one side is steeper or sharper than the other side. Here's how you can create a similar curve with just basic EQ shapes rather than having to get the Waves EQ or anything like that. So I'll go ahead and bring up my vocals, talk about why you might want to do something like this. Here are my lead vocals. You're going to see on here the spectrum when the guy starts singing.
We were heading into town with the radio loud. She was sitting shotgun at her window rolled down, took everything.
So you can see, so a lot of the voiced portions of his singing have harmonics that are in the low mids and so on. But what you want to avoid is the upper mids and the high frequencies where the sibilant sounds are. Those are the S's and the S sounds, the S kinds of sounds that you a lot of times end up using a special processor just for those things. The high frequency sounds that can sound harsh. You want to avoid boosting those things. But I want to boost with a pretty wide Q around the 1,000 to 2,000 and 3,000, but then I want to have a sharp drop-off that happens around 3,000, so I'm not boosting those high frequencies. So I'll go ahead here, turn these off, go over to band 5 and 6 that I've already got set up together here. This one's boosting at 2 dB, and then I've got 6 over here that I've got minus 2. So right now it's a flat curve because these are interacting with each other. So what I can do here is move this one to the right. You'll see, just as before, that the curves are interacting with each other. I could stretch this out and have a flat top. But what I wouldn't do is have a bell curve like this, but then make this one more sharp. So it's I'm cutting out the high frequencies, but can boost more across the ones here. So if I go over to band 6, what I'm going to do is sharpen that Q. You'll see what happens. It all of a sudden becomes asymmetrical. I'm boosting more of the low frequencies as part of the bell curve, but then the highs, I'm cutting them off. These are the harsh sounds I'm going to try and avoid boosting, right? So now I'm accomplishing an asymmetrical shape. I could do the same thing, flip it the other side if that's what my application called for. So let me play you back my vocals and let you hear this.
We were heading into town with the radio loud. She was sitting shotgun at her window rolled down, took everything I had not to pull her close to me. Trying not to move too fast, cause I wanted all the last. Could be the only shot I ever have. And if it goes my way, I'll be the only man she'll ever need.
Pull it out like this.
Like Jack and Diane, we could fall in love. Like Bonnie and Clyde, we'd be kicking up dust. Like Johnny and June, no one ever give up. That could be us.
So hopefully you can see what I was demonstrating there is by just using these basic building blocks, these shapes like a high shelf, you can do the same thing here with bells as you would with high shelves too, just like I did on the previous example. What you have control over with the Q, the frequency and gain, you have these degrees of freedom where you can change the shape. I can make this one flatter on one side, or I can sharpen it like this. I can go over to band 6 now. I can decide how flat or sharp I want to make this one. And they're interacting together in this nice way. Instead of just, you know, using one particular equalizer that has a special curve for it, by building it out of two separate equalizer shapes, you have a lot more control. So there you go, guys. I hope you learned some new tricks. Maybe I even saved you a couple bucks by showing you how you can use a simple EQ plugin that you already have rather than having to go out and buy another one. Let me know what you think, and take care, guys. I'll catch you next time.